I think in science, failing is not necessarily something bad. It's just a learning. I mean, you cannot really have positive results every time. Otherwise, it's not really science. You need to fail to be able to obtain good results. My name is Herve. I'm a chemist by training, and I work in our compound management group where we house the compounds collection. And our mission is to distribute these compounds to all over the organization. The compound archive itself is a treasure because it gathers compounds that were produced by many, many teams years ago. And it's a very large panel of real hard work from people over years and all over the organization. I think delivering compounds is a big responsibility because we are really at the start of all the research. It's not easy actually when you keep in mind that we have 1.5 million compounds just to be able at any time to track where the compound is. It's only a few years afterwards sometimes that you have the pleasure to see, okay, now it's in a clinical phase and this is actually a compound that we delivered during this assay. I think in sport or in science, it's the same principle that at one point you feel just stuck. Coaching kids gives me a lot of pleasure to see how they can evolve. So when you combine different disciplines, then you obtain very good results. If I consider basketball, it's not the point to have players that are all shooters, because that won't bring anything. But if you manage to mix shooters with guys that take rebounds, you really can achieve something. Everybody can contribute in a different way. Maybe the impact is more visible for some of them, but I think everybody brings something to the final goal.